Diclofenac, sold under the brand name Voltaren, Trust Studded, Pharmasal Gel, among others, is a nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drug, NSAID, used to treat pain and inflammatory diseases such as gout. In this video, let's find found. What is Diclofenac? What is Diclofenac used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking Diclofenac? How does Diclofenac work? How to use Diclofenac? What is Diclofenac? Diclofenac, sold under the brand name Voltaren, Trust Studded, Pharmasal Gel, among others, is a nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drug, NSAID, used to treat pain and inflammatory diseases such as gout. Diclofenac was patented in 1965 by G.R. Geigy AG. It came into medical use in the United States in 1988. It is available as a generic medication. In 2020, it was the 72nd most commonly prescribed medication in the United States, with more than 9 million prescriptions. What is Diclofenac used for? Diclofenac is indicated for use in the treatment of pain and inflammation from varying sources, including inflammatory conditions such as osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, and ankylosing spondylitis, as well as injury-related inflammation due to surgery and physical trauma. It is often used in combination with misoprostol as a gastroprotective agent in patients with high risk of developing NSAID-induced ulcers. Contraindication. Diclofenac is contraindicated in the following patients. Known hypersensitivity, example, anaphylactic reactions and serious skin reactions, to diclofenac or any components of the drug product. History of asthma, urticaria, or other allergic-type reactions after taking aspirin or other NSAIDs. Severe, sometimes fatal, anaphylactic reactions to NSAIDs have been reported in such patients. In the setting of CABG surgery. Side effects. Some common side effects of diclofenac are feeling sick, nausea, being sick, vomiting, or diarrhea, feeling dizzy or vertigo, headaches, stomach ache, wind or loss of appetite, mild rash. Pharmacodynamic. Diclofenac reduces inflammation and by extension reduces nociceptive pain and combats fever. It also increases the risk of developing a gastrointestinal ulcer by inhibiting the production of protective mucus in the stomach. Mechanism of action. Diclofenac inhibits cyclooxygenase 1 and minus 2, the enzymes responsible for production of prostaglandin, PG, G2, which is the precursor to other PGs. These molecules have broad activity in pain and inflammation, and the inhibition of their production is the common mechanism linking each effect of diclofenac. PGE2 is the primary PG involved in modulation of nociception. By limiting sensitization, both peripheral and central, via these pathways, NSAIDs can effectively reduce inflammatory pain. PGI2 and PGE2 contribute to acute inflammation via their IP and EP2 receptors. By limiting the production of these PGs at the site of injury, NSAIDs can reduce inflammation. PGE2 can cross the blood-brain barrier and act on excitatory GQEP3 receptors on thermoregulatory neurons in the hypothalamus. This activation triggers an increase in heat generation and a reduction in heat loss to produce a fever. NSAIDs prevent the generation of PGE2, thereby reducing the activity of these neurons. Half-life. The terminal half-life of diclofenac is approximately 2H, however the apparent half-life including all metabolites is August 25, 33H. Half-life. The terminal half-life of diclofenac is approximately 2H, however the apparent half-life including all metabolites is August 25, 33H. Safety advice. It belongs to a class of drug called NSAIDs, nonsteroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. This leaflet summarizes the effects of diclofenac and other NSAIDs on a baby in the womb. Use of diclofenac during pregnancy is not advised unless prescribed by a doctor, especially if you are 30 or more weeks pregnant. That's all the information about diclofenac we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.